Welcome back friends. In this video, we are going to talk about how to configure Lambot in IntelliJ and Eclipse. Use of Lambot is we can generate getter setter method and constructor dynamically using Lambot library. We don't have to write getter setter code manually. We don't have to write constructors manually. We can give those tasks to Lambot. Lambot will take care of generating those things. That is the main purpose of Lambot. There are many features also. Let's see here. User class. I created a user class. The user class having some attributes. For this attribute, I have not created a getter and setter method. There is a one tag called @data. Using that @data, we can generate getter setter method dynamically at runtime. We don't have to write those getter setter by ourselves. In order to do this, first you need to include Lambot artifact in your pom.xml. Then you need to follow some configuration in your IDE. If you are using IntelliJ, you need to do following configuration. Go to File, Settings, Plugins. In the Plugins, search Lambot. It will come a result like that. I have already installed Lambot in my IntelliJ. That is the reason it's disabled and it says installed. So I don't have to install here. It's already installed. In your case, this search will come with the install enabled button. Okay, you can click that. Once you click that, follow the installation instruction and click next. Your installation completed. Then you have to do other settings. Go to File, Settings, Build Execution Deployment. Double click that. There is a compiler option. Double click that. Here you can see annotation processor. Make sure that this annotation processor enabled. Make sure that this annotation process enabled. Okay, sometimes this will not work after installing Lambot plugin. The Lambot will not work properly. In such a case, go to here, select annotation processor. Click the checkbox, enable annotation processing, then apply, okay. Okay, that's it. You have done with the Lambot configuration. Now, you need to restart your IDE. I am restarting now. Now, create one test method. Inside the class, I am going to create one class called test class. Here user class does not have a getter and a setter, right? So user equal to new user. Import that. User.set first name. Set last name. Then get first name. Then get last name. Run this application. See first name phrase. Oh, here last name. That is doesn't matter. We are checking only the Lambot is working or not without generating the getter setter. Okay, now now Lombak configuration perfectly working, because in this user class I have not created setter getter method, but I am able to access setter getter method here. That meaning our Lombak is configured perfectly in the IntelliJ. These are the steps you need to follow to configure Lombak. Okay, now we are going to see how to configure Lombak in Eclipse Editor and Eclipse based IDE. That meaning FTS. FTS also Eclipse based IDE. Whatever step I'll going to show now, that same step you can follow for FTS IDE also. Okay. These are Eclipse I have downloaded. Extract here. I'm extracting that. These are brand new Eclipse. Opening Eclipse now. I want to create my own project. File, new, others, my own project, next. Next, back, oh, create a simple project. Okay, select the create a simple project. Next, com.itgarden group ID, Lombak demo, finish. Okay, I have created a simple Maven project. Go to IntelliJ. Here I have artifact. Just copy this artifact. Dependencies, just paste here. It is asking version, which version you want to use. I have a version here. Okay, that's it. Now Lombak artifact I have added. New class. Just I want to create one test class. In that class I want to execute one SOP. SOP nothing but system.out.println. Just make sure that it's working or not. My new Eclipse. This is test. I want to see that Maven run as Maven install. It may not be work. I'm expecting. Yeah, it's working fine. Sometime what will happen, the JDK not properly configured. That's the reason I am testing here, the basic stuff is working or not. Yeah, my JDK pointing correctly. Sometimes it's not pointing correctly here. Instead of this, it will point to JRE. That time you'll be facing some error. That time you need to change to correct your JDK path. Okay, here it's correct everything. I'm going to create one class called user class. Then copy this attribute, only this attribute. I already added the Lombak artifact, so I can use data annotation tag. Here I'm going to initialize that user class. User dot get, nothing is coming. That is whatever attributes I mentioned here, for those attributes I'm expecting getter and setter method, because I have added add data annotation. This add data annotation coming from Lombak. Use of this add data annotation, it will generate getter and setter method automatically. We don't have to generate manually, but here it's not coming. When I say user.get, nothing is coming. That meaning Lombax is not configured properly. Even I have added artifact in pom.xml, then I have added the data annotation, but still here getter setter method is not coming. That meaning Lombax is not installed properly. In order to configure properly, we have to follow some steps in Eclipse. This is my installation location. This is my Eclipse installation location. D:\test:eclipse. Keep remember that. Then go to user Suresh. This is my user folder. For your computer, you need to go your user folder. Go to M2. This is a Maven repository. Click repository. Then go to org. Then go to project Lombax. Here is a project Lombax. Go to this plot. In your case, user, your username .m2 repository org project Lombax. We are using 1.18.112, I think. Let's check that. Yeah, we are using the same version. Go inside that folder. Copy this path. Go to command prompt. Go to that location. Whatever location here, right? Go to that location. Run following command. java -jar. What is the jar file? This jar file, right? Copy this jar file. Paste it here. .jar. When you say like this, one window will come. This is a Lombax installation window. It's saying that I cannot find any IDEs on your computer. That is, Lombax installer not able to find the IDE, Eclipse IDE. That's fine. Okay. Click that. Click that specify location button. Our Eclipse installation location is D:\test:eclipse, right? Copy this path. And I mentioned here, see that location come here. This is a, we need to provide our Eclipse installation location. Once that added properly here, click install update. After clicking, this window should come. If Lombax installed properly, this window will come install successfully. That's it. You are done with the Lombax configuration. Then click the quit installer. Now we need to restart the Eclipse. Before that, try to check that get, still it's not coming. Okay, still it's not coming. So restart your Eclipse. See here, now it's coming. Get first name, get last name, get middle name, mobile name, whatever attribute I have mentioned in the user class, those attribute I'm able to see when I say dot. When I say dot, I'm able to see all these attribute here. Okay. So now Lombax is installed perfectly in our Eclipse. The same step you need to follow for STS also. No difference. Now I want to test this. Run as Java application. Oh, sorry. Why this? What happened? Set first name. Yeah. Think probably it's a build problem. We'll going to build it again. Maven, run as Maven install. Yeah, now its error is gone. The problem is build error. Okay, that's the reason it's not recognized. Set even the user if you say user dot, it's showing the set first name, get first name, everything, but Eclipse showing the compilation error. That is because of builder problem. After building, that error is disappeared. Now time to run this Java class. See here, I'm able to. What is this? Yeah. So here I'm able to see the. I'm able to use the get first name, set first name, get last name, set last name. So Lambac is working perfectly in our system, in our Eclipse. That's it, guys. We're going to talk in next video with the good topics. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Hello, friends. Hope you're doing good. I think you may know that I am developing a billing application using Spring Boot. I am developing this application for who is looking for real-time project experience in Spring Boot. It is good for students as well as job seekers. Also, I am developing this billing application for small retail shop owners. My intention is every small retailer in India wanted to use this application and wanted to make their environment digital. Not only India, I would like to provide this service across the world. I am planning to give this application for free for students as well as shop owners. They don't have to pay any money for that. Still, I have not completed this application. It is in progress. I think it will take next 3 months to complete the application. But day by day, I am updating in my YouTube channel what is the progress of billing application, what is the progress of developing the billing application. Please go and check playlist called Billing System Project Development using Spring Boot. I have given all the updates in the playlist. I am getting good response from the audience. I am very happy to see those responses. Thank you so much, guys. I would like to do a service whatever I can. So I am planning to teach Java for cheapest price. It will be very helpful for poor people who wanted to learn Java. Of course, it will be useful for rich people also. Anyone can join. I never charge like 7k, 10k, 20k. It will be even less than 5k for each topic in Java. I need at least 5 people in a batch. I need one help from you. I need at least 5 people in a batch, 5 to 10 people, so that I can manage financially. Please call me or WhatsApp me to this number. We will talk. Definitely, I will give you good interactive session with more practicals. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.